Oh yeah, I forgot. Oh, hey guys, I'm gonna explain why the intro is kind of a bit different. We're gonna have a live action intro, not really a meme or any made up skit, so I'm just here to explain why we're a bit late on the video. I did say that I was gonna make this video, which is the Why I Hate Miles Morales video, on Tuesday, but it's Wednesday, so it don't really matter that it's Wednesday, it just matters that the video's delayed. But I'm making it now, and I'm trying to think about any other reasons I probably delayed the video. I know, I think I did. There's like stuff that happened like the last couple weeks or something. It's just like, I can't find it on the top of my head. That's kind of where my hair used to be, but is it on the floor? I don't know. It's whatever. But we're going to get to the video now, so I hope everybody enjoys. Yeah, everybody, I got a haircut. I was trying to get the Mr. Clean Cut, but apparently we don't have razors in our house that cut properly, I guess, even though I shave my face all the time, but it's whatever. Let's get to the main point. The video everybody's been waiting for. We're going to talk about why I hate Miles Morales. I know it's not anybody else who hates him, because it's obviously going to be me. I'm not doing a collab with like 30 people. But I'm just going to get to the chase. We're going to have 5 chapters. I'm going to put them up right now. Okay, but I see some good. So I'm going to explain why I hate Miles Morales in depth. I'm probably going to have a couple screenshots if I can find them, because I want to explain why his character is basically F-tier garbage, and I would really love to stop seeing him. Anyways, let's move on to the video. For number one is going to be the odd hook, because I don't know what happened to the Spider-Man fan base the last 10, actually, I think the last 8 years. Because they went from completely normal people to just weird nut jobs. Because everybody who seems to be a Spider-Man fan seems to be like a closeted racist or something. Because anyone who says they hate Miles Morales immediately just assumes that the person hates him because he's black. I'm going to clear this up so quick right now. I do not hate Miles Morales because he's black. That's a very shallow reason to hate a character. Even though one of his character traits is, I'm black, or I'm a black Spider-Man. That's basically it. Eric July said that he's basically Peter Darker, which I found hilarious, but it's whatever. Miles Morales' race does not matter. He would still be a garbage character if he was a white guy, an Asian dude, even an alien. Dude is just complete garbage as a character. I don't like his character, and we're going to get into that. But before we get into the second part, I'm going to go tell you about one little thing I've been working on. I have a comic line that no one really knows about, because both the comics got thrown out to 2 separate times. That could be their own stories, but in my comics, I actually wanted to make a black Spider-Man of my own. I called him Nathan Portman. I don't have a good picture of him, because I don't have a colored picture of him. I only made one image, and that's it. But I think he would be a fantastic character if I developed him properly. So we're going to get in. Actually, we're not going to get into that. What am I talking about? Yeah, let's get into stage 2. I think I was having a brain fart. I meant 0.2 or just 2. It's whatever, but I think I was also having a brain fart in that last take or whatever. So we're going to get over the little power I actually figured out about Spider-Man, because people do realize that Peter Parker has been with a lot of women. And apparently in the comics, he's supposed to look nerdy, or let's say ugly, or ugly for Marvel's sake, because he looks like an average guy. But he pulls all these like nearly 10 out of 10 women like a lot. Like a lot. I could probably find a couple screenshots or whatever, but I think it's due to a power he has that no one ever talks about. Spider-Riz, apparently. I called it that because I think it's funny, but looking at Miles, he is probably like 50 times uglier than this dude, and at first, I didn't even know if he had any love interest or anything, because it's like, I never really hear about Miles getting a girlfriend or looking for anybody or whatever, but he apparently had 5 of them, and 2 of them are Spider-Gwens, which is really dumb. Like, I just think that's a bit ridiculous for them to even ship Gwen with freaking Miles of all people. Because I think about it, and it's like, you look at the other 3 of the 5 women that Miles is with. I think all 3 of them were technically token characters too, just like him. So yeah, you do attract your own kind eventually. But then 2 of them are freaking Gwen of all people. It's like, What do I even say? Dude don't have no one he likes at school. He don't got no chicks he can, like, mingle with. But no, he just ended up picking up another Peter Parker ex, who is Gwen Stacy. Holy crap, this dude's unoriginal. And I just think that's kind of a waste. I don't think, let's say normally, they would have good chemistry, because in the new Spider-Verse movie, I don't know why they had to make Gwen a piece of crap with that flag above her room. But I don't think they'd usually mangle. It's like, those two people wouldn't exactly be like that, you know? Gwen is a baddie and all, but holy crap, putting her in Miles, that's just terrible. That's a waste of his own. Like, bro. Okay, let's go to the third part before I had the thought of punching this dude's teeth on the floor. I meant I would knock his teeth out onto the floor. But with number three, he's basically a copy and paste of Peter Parker nearly every way, just with a bit of changes. So, basically, Miles is bit by a spider the same way Peter was, let's say randomly, because let's give him the benefit of the doubt. Dude lives with, instead of his aunt, you know, his aunt and his uncle, he just lives with his mom and dad, and he just has an uncle, because why not? So, Miles, in any reality, basically, except for the PlayStation 4 game, he's closer with his uncle than he is his mom and dad, yada, yada, yada. This dude then realizes he's a supervillain, and Prowler dies, or let's say Uncle Aaron, because that's who he is. He dies, basically like Spider-Man. Both their uncles are dead, of course, by being different people. Uncle Aaron was a bad guy, and at his last moments, basically wanted Miles to be a better man, which that was in vain. And Uncle Ben was a good person who was caught in the wrong situation. Then you have, of course, what I just said, they both dated Gwen Stacy, of all people. Oh, and this funny one that people always bring up. Miles does not have his own rogues gallery, because Prowler, instead of being Hobby Brown, is his uncle. He also fought the Rhino, who is a Spider-Man villain. He just fights Spider-Man villains. There was, like, a couple exceptions, like the Tanker, who I think was a decent character, but for his game, they race-swap Tanker, which is stupid. Oh my. Just stuff like that. He doesn't have his own rogues gallery. He doesn't have really any women that he correlates with. He doesn't really even have his own stories, because all the recent Spider-Man events, they were all with Peter Parker. Not really Miles Morales-centered, except for, like, the Spider-Verse movies, but that's different. Peter's still there, though. That's not really his own story. What do you think about that? Miles Morales, in the core, is a nothing character, because in the deepest of core, he's a black Spider-Man. Outside of that, he's a clone of Peter Parker. And outside of that, I'm going to get into that at number four, because he's complete garbage. And with number four, we're going to get into Miles' personality and the main thing I hate about him. He isn't a superhero. He's a piece of subhuman garbage. So, we're going to go with the very first thing he does. So, in the comics, Miles Morales, figures out that Peter Parker's dead. He's like, oh crap, I guess they don't have a superhero in that area anymore. And then Uncle Aaron brings a spider out of his backpack, and I guess the spider jumps on the Miles and bites him. And he's like, well, I have the powers of Spider-Man, now I know what to do. So he basically jumps around as Spider-Man. People, of course, rightly say you don't wear the outfit of a dead superhero like that. This is the only time Miles Morales actually shows morality. And he's like, oh crap, I didn't mean to do that. I'll be my own Spider-Man. And then here's where it goes downhill. So, as a character, this dude, completely nothing. He has the same villains as Spider-Man, and basically lives a pretty identical life. Except it isn't as bad, because the editors would get fired for being racist if they made Miles have 1 ounce of struggle in anything. So, Miles, I'm just going to get down to the complete bottom cracks of his personality. I'm going to go with the most obvious one. Being a freaking racist, of all people. I don't care what they'd show you in your face or in any media, the comics, the movies, I don't care. It's just weird that Miles, in the comics, let's say he likes Peter or whatever, I would think, as a character, it's like, I don't think he likes white people. He probably doesn't like anybody except for black people. He's probably a whole black supremacist. He is part of BLM, of all things, which is ridiculously stupid and completely racist. Because I think either, I don't know if it came in a comic first, but the first time I was aware of it was actually a BLM pride skin and whatever. I think it's like Black Pride or whatever. It's stupid. It was a DLC skin in the Miles Morales game, because at first I'm just thinking, okay, the game's just out. Okay, I don't care. And then they have a BLM skin of all things, and I'm like, that is completely stupid. That is actually stupid. And then I didn't notice this in the movie, but he also has a BLM pin on his freaking thing in the new Spider-Verse movie. That's another reason I'm going to knock his teeth out. Actually, I'm going to make sure he swallows some of them when I punch the crap out of him. If he was even a real guy, I would definitely just do a lot of fighting moves on that dude if I saw him in person. But other than that, Miles is a piece of garbage like that. I don't think he's considerate. He only cares about his own neighborhood and stuff, and I don't even think he's being a superhero for the right reasons. And it just hurts my soul that in the Spider-Verse movies, Peter gets a likening to Miles, because I guess it's like Peter in the movies wasn't really confident about being a parent, so he's like, hey, why not train with Miles? Even though a baby and a teenager are two different things. And Peter grows a bond with him, and he learns basically from him that he would be a good father. So that happens, and my entire soul basically got ripped in half at that exact moment. I figured that out. It's just like, he did all that because of Miles. A piece of human garbage. Like, honestly, I would not stop until my finger, all the bones in my hands are broken. But it's just whatever. So that happens. Miles is the new Spider-Man of his universe, because his universe Spider-Man died and whatever. And just like, dude is just also, if you think about it, he's pretty much disrespectful, because BLM is main enemy other than white people, and I guess other black people, because every time BLM riots, it's always in black neighborhoods for some reason, is police. BLM does not like the police. And you know what Miles' dad is? He is a police officer. That's like being part of an arsonist group when your dad is a firefighter. That is sheer disrespect on multiple levels. Miles' dad is a cop. A perfect role model to look up to as a good person. Because let's say Miles' dad isn't like him at all. He's actually a good person. He helps the community. He stops crime. And he works his junction pretty well. Then he has a kid, Miles, who's a piece of garbage. It's like he came out of his mom's butt instead of the other end. And this piece of crap decides, I want to go basically against my dad's job. Because his dad, police officer. Everybody knows that already. But then he just goes into BLM, and I would think that he would probably conflict with his dad a lot, because he is a police officer, and they would probably not like each other because of that. And it's just stuff like that. I don't know. If you know about the BLM stuff and how Miles as a character is on a somewhat deeper level, he is complete human scum. He probably only is a superhero just because, I don't know, I'm going to assume it's like a very shallow reason. It's like he's being a superhero because, I guess no one else will, and I guess I could just be a superhero, take glory or whatever. Like a dang narcissist. Because I don't see any care in this man. I will look past all the charades that everybody puts in my face that he's a superhero. No, he isn't a superhero. He is a racist, neglectful, disrespectful piece of garbage. I would uppercut this dude until he had his own funeral. I hate Miles Morales with every being of my fiber. If I can grow hair for every hair I hate about him, I would look like my cats. This dude is literally bottom tier. You have all these Spider-Men, and they keep choosing Miles. That's going to be more talked about in number 5, but I'm not finished with this verbal assault on him yet. Miles, he's just pieces of garbage. Every little mannerism he does, it just exhumes of being a douche. It's like he's a punk or something. Like, he's the type of guy you go to the gas station and he just stares at you like you just killed his kid or something. No reason for hating you, he just hates you just because. That's the type of guy Miles is. He is a complete scumbag. He's the type of dude who sags his pants to his ankles and wears a shirt longer than Tennessee. He goes to a gas station, slaps the back of your head, and then buys your freaking stuff. You know, with half price, and you just can't do anything. Who knows? Dude's a freaking, he is like evil incarnate. He is like what happens when you give powers to a very evil person. Because I don't know much about Miles 100%, but I know that some part of him is very egotistical. It's like he wears the idea of Spider-Man with pride because, hey, look, I'm a Spider-Man, and Spider-Man's so looked highly upon. And it's kind of like when you get it's like that one person, it's like a very evil person gets a job and then gloats about it. He just seems like that to me, and I do not like that one bit. So let's go to section 5 and finally end this long section off. Number 5. I would think if Miles was a real person, I would just straight up hate this guy. You guys already know the video, but and also the thing, it's more like if Miles just like, it just, Miles' entire existence. If I could just say one phrase to show you how I feel, it would be more like, get the fuck out of my face, and that'd probably be a good start. Because if I ever met Miles, by the time, there would be no evidence of his existence by the time I took my hands off him. I, unlike him, am a real man. Because if I see him do anything, lay a hand on freaking Gwen, go anywhere near me, or my eyes, or my ears, I see him in any media, I will uppercut this dude into the stratosphere. I will basically beat this dude up like I'm DT who just called Dale Wilson lacking outside. I will treat this dude like he is the car stage in Street Fighter. I'll treat this dude like he is the test your might board. I would literally smash this dude's face into oblivion. I would literally ride this dude down my stairs with barbed wire on it until he has no skin left, until his bone is showing. I would love to do every single Mortal Kombat fatality on this dude 5 times over. I would break every bone in his body until he stopped crying. I would throw this dude over multiple clouds just to see how far I can throw him. I would slap this dude so hard I would tear my own skin off. I would literally show this dude every type of martial art to his face, literally. I just don't like Miles. I hate Miles as a character. I hate him as a person. I hate him as Spider-Man. I hate him in every single fiber of my being. He is a fictional character, and I never really think about many people in real life that give me like that. Miles Morales just sucks in every way of it. Everybody keeps dick riding him, and he's only popular with normies and weird people. Weird racist people. People who type racial slurs in their basement when their mic's not working on Call of Duty. Those fans who like Miles Morales are suck-ups. They are freaking token lovers. They are weirdos. They are closet racists themselves. They are just weird. I do not really trust many people who like Miles at all. I don't care what the movies or comics or anything says about Miles. I'm still going to hate the character. I will uppercut this dude, like, somewhere. I don't even need an uppercut. At this point, I want to downercut this dude into hell. I will show this man every flame there is in hell. The gnashing of teeth. The freaking breaking of this man's jays. I will tear them apart with my bare teeth like I'm a dog. And I will show him to every crackhead at every 7-Eleven or gas station and have them stab him with coke needles. I will put coke in his blood. I will uppercut this dude. I will beat the crap out of this dude so hard forensics files will puke. It's going to look like one of the dead bodies in NCIS. I'm going to freaking throw this dude into the river that's made of lava. If we were playing Minecraft together, I would keep blowing up his base. I will literally go in creative and spawn mini TNT on this dude. I'll make this dude so scared of me. Just the smell of me will make this dude cower in the shower. This dude will be scared as bricks. I will literally just do every single impossible thing to him. If he were real, of course. I'm just saying, in drawings, I could do definitely anything. I could draw myself beating the freaking whistle out of this dude every moment of my being. I don't hate this dude all the time, but every time he enters my head, I immediately am filled with hatred. I hate this guy. He is the complete opposite of how I am with people I love, because when I love you, I will die for you. I will love you till the end of existence. For people I hate, if I hate you, I will hate you until my heart gives out. I will hate you until you are dead, and after that, I will still hate you. There is no freaking forgiveness for a man that I feel of hatred. I hate this dude. I hope everybody has a good day and isn't too unsettled by the video. Make sure to like, subscribe, probably check out my friends' channels. Do a backflip, I don't know. Comment stuff. Adios.